Welcome back to the show. My next guest is a talented young actor, Brandon Lee, whose new film, Rapid Fire, opens August 21st. How you doing?
Doing good. Thank
you. Nice to meet you. And you're also a martial artist, right?
Have been all my life, yes.
All your life?
Since the time I could walk.
Your dad, Bruce Lee, I guess, taught you from an early age. And one thing I want to ask you right off, is there a move that you can do, or that martial artists do, where you reach up into a stomach, pull out somebody's heart?
And show it to them before they die.
Yeah, yeah.
Just to see the surprised look on their face.
Yeah, well, this is what I've heard, and I've always wondered, how could they practice this move? Do they reach into the refrigerator, pass the oatmeal,
That's
grab the
Chinese
Jell-O?
That's why Chinese have so many children. Just so you can practice.
Okay, you're the youngest. Oh, all right.
It's easier on the little ones,
No, too. Have you ever heard of that?
I've heard about it, too. Can't say as how I've seen anybody do it or done it myself recently.
But does it exist? I mean, you know what I mean? Has any, you know, did your dad tell you it could happen or no, you know, I mean, it's been bugging me for years.
Yeah, we used to have these secret conferences in the back room at the house. Mom would get the pot of tea and bring it in, you know, kind of like this. Hurt like hell, too. I can't say as how I know much about that one, sorry.
Now, what do you study? Because, like, when I was a kid growing up, it was karate, judo, and boxing, and street fights. But what do you call your specific type of martial arts? What are you studying?
My father's art was called Jeet Kune Do, and that's what I've trained into.
Did he start that? Or?
Yeah, he originated it while he was alive.
Now, what's the difference between that and other, you know, is it a whole different philosophy, or?
Well, it's kind of an involved question, but essentially in the mid-60s, when my dad came over from Hong Kong, all of the different styles of martial arts were very much unto themselves, and there wasn't any kind of transfer of information going on between different arts. And in fact, when my dad first started teaching in San Francisco in the early 60s to white people, he came under a great degree of criticism from the Chinese community there in San Francisco for teaching to white people, you know, because that's how ossified they were. And what my dad did is he took and combined what he considered to be the best from the different techniques that he had studied and added along with those techniques some things that were essentially his own to create the art that he called Jeet Kune Do.
A lot of people said the rumor when your dad passed away that these Chinese guys killed him because he was giving away too many secrets.
Well, you know, the thing is, those rumors to me are really on the same level as Elvis sightings at a local McDonald's.
Okay. Well, I mean, I didn't mean to be insensitive, but this is, you know, it's like the stomach.
Well, my mom's written a couple real good biographies about my dad, and they really lay out the facts of his life for anybody who's interested.
Now, you left home, you hitchhiked across the country, you got kicked out of high school a lot. Were you a troublemaker?
I guess so. Seems like such a long time ago, but the last time they kicked me out, what did they write on the piece of paper? It said, that I had a bad attitude towards the educational process and was a poisonous influence upon the minds of my fellow students.
Wow, that's pretty impressive.
So now I get to be on television and be a poisonous influence to the minds of everyone who watches.
Now, did you really hitchhike around the country?
Yeah, I did.
How old were you?
17.
Because I've always, you know, at 17, I didn't have the mind to do that, but I'm envious of guys who took off, you know, at a young age and hitchhiked. I mean, if I did it now, I'd probably get killed or something, but...
It was great, I'm telling you. I was just, I guess it would have been about, what, 1982?
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like I just caught some kind of last wave of people who were into stuff like that, you know? I used to catch rides with these guys who were older than me at the time, you know, men and women, and they'd say, God, you are going to have the best time. I did stuff like this when I was your age. I don't know, it's kind of a long, silly story, but I must have read all the wrong books in high school or something.
On the road with Kerouac?
Of course.
Yeah. Oh, and you can't do that now because it's all super highways.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess so.
How'd you get into acting?
From a real young age, it's what I wanted to do. I went to college and studied theater. I was working in Los Angeles doing coverage for a producer, reading scripts and writing synopses of them. And I auditioned for this television movie of the week, and it was my first job.
And you rewrote, I read a lot of the fight scenes to your new film, Rapid Fire.
Along with the stunt coordinator, Jeff Imada, we did the choreography for the film. Yeah.
How long does that take to choreograph those, especially martial arts scenes? It seems like it's very difficult and time-consuming.
Well, it's just a process. You know, you sit down with the script, you tear out the pages the writer wrote and throw them away, and then you just make it up. Then I'd bring some guys from the martial arts academy that I practice at over to the house. I'd rehearse it with them to see that it worked as well in the flesh as it did on paper. If there was something that I felt was particularly camera dependent, I'd shoot it on video to make sure it worked. Then I'd bring all that into the director and the DP, and they'd modify it, and then we'd have rehearsal time, and then we'd shoot it.
Okay, we're going to take a look at a clip, action clip of Rapid Fire. You want to set this up at all, or?
This was the biggest action set piece in the movie just because of the sheer scale of the thing, and we shot this thing for like 7 days, and it went on and on, and if we get to the part in this clip where the ceiling collapses, I'll tell you a story about it afterwards because it was pretty funny.
Okay, well, hopefully we'll get to that part. Here's Rapid Fire, Brandon Way.
We got cops out here.
Wow. All I can say is wow. Has it ever happened to you in real life?
Oh, just like that all
the
time. No.
Do you ever get in fights? So, like, you know, people find out that you're a martial artist and they want to mess with you.
It used to happen a lot more often when I was younger. You know, I try to be a pretty peaceful guy.
And happy with the way the movie turned out. When you're watching that, are you thinking, you know, I could have done the triple quarter move or whatever you call them, you know, do you look at that and kind of...
Always.
Yeah.
Always.
Was working at it. And what's coming up next for you? Would you like to continue with these type of films or...
I've still got a couple tricks up my sleeve as far as these types of films go that I wouldn't mind seeing make it to the screen. But actually next I'm playing a rock and roll musician in a film called The Crow.
And is he also a martial artist?
No, actually he's... He gets murdered and then returns from the dead.
Brandon, we're out of time. Thanks a lot for being on the show.
Thanks, man.
The name of the film again?
Rapid Fire.
Rapid Fire opens August 21st. Sorry, that blew me away. We'll be right back after this.